In real life projects, the code evolves, and I have Git to manage the changes. And in real life projects, the database evolves too. For Python projects, I have Alembic, which will manage the changes for the database schema. Alembic can also handle conflicts from team changes. Working on a team project, I used to see my codebase change every day, and sometimes those changes require adaptations on the database schema. Here comes Alembic. Alembic is like Git. Git is for the codebase. Alembic is for the database schema. Each modification on the code is associated to a commit in Git. Each modification on the database schema is associated to a revision in Alembic. Having a tool to manage the database changes helped me to keep track of those changes. If the changes are manually, I may forget to run the queries at some rollout. With Alembic, I ensure the database upgrades at the same time as the codebase. With manual scripts, I may not be sure that I've run them on all the environments, and I must share them with all the developers to upgrade their local database. With Alembic, I ensure that all the environments have the codebase synchronized with the database schema. Another advantage of tools like Alembic is that if there is a problem and I want to roll back one version of code, Alembic allows me to also roll back the database schema easily. With Alembic, each new modification on the database will be done in a separated file. Within this file, I will also include the rollback operation. The migration will be done with the SQL Alchemy engine. This means that I don't require SQL knowledge, and I'm even agnostic to the database system. It could be Oracle, Postgres, or MySQL. Alembic has multiple commands to manage the migrations, the rollbacks, the status, and even to merge some conflicts. Let's start by adding the dependency. I have my project managed by Poetry, so the command is this. It will be pip install alembic if I'm working directly with pip. I will now enter in my Poetry shell to be agnostic of the dependency management tool. If you want to know more about Poetry, just check the link in the corner. And now I must initialize alembic like this. This command created me a folder where will be located all the migrations, the configuration to connect to the database, and the templates used to create new migration scripts. The first thing I notice is that I must edit the alembic.ini file before proceeding. I can see here some general configurations, but the one I'm interested in is the URL of the database. When running Alembic, it will use by default this file. Nevertheless, I can indicate to use a different configuration file, where can be located the URL of different databases, the databases of the other environments. If the connection to the database is more complicated, I must use environment variables to get the password, I have multiple databases to connect, or other complications, I can edit the connection directly in the env.py file, where the connection is created. Okay, that's it. Alembic is ready to be used. I will create my first migration script. This command creates a file where I can add my operations to modify the database. The OP object gives me access to plenty of operations with the database. Table creations, table modifications, drop tables, create index, and more. And the SE object is SQL Alchemy. Here I create my first table, the country table, with three columns. And in the downgrade method, I write my rollback operation. So my migration is ready. Let's run it. This will run all the migration files until the last one. If wanted, I could specify the hash version of a specific version, until which I want to upgrade. That's not my case. Let's continue with another migration quickly to see the dependencies. In the upgrade method, I create the user table, nothing new, but I also create a foreign key with the previously created country table. And in the downgrade method, as before, drop the table. But now, how to use the rollback command? I've indicated to rollback, to downgrade just one revision. I could indicate to downgrade until a specific revision too. And now I can go forward again, as before. As this is my second migration script, I have the current revision ID and the previous one. This creates a relation between both. The migration of the user table needs the country table to be created. Here I can see the dependencies between my two migration scripts. This allows me to easily go forward and backward, just following the dependencies between the revisions. The case is that the development of some features is done in separated branches, by different people, which lead to conflicts. Let's see how Alembic can handle this. I will create my first branch, with a single migration script. In this migration script, I create two tables, with their foreign keys, and with the related rollbacks methods where I drop the tables. No complication, right? Let's go back to the main branch, and create a second feature branch with another migration script. More tables, more foreign keys, and the rollback method. If I print the history of any of my feature branches, I will see just a downgrade dependency from the main branch. But what happens when I merge both branches on the main branch? I face now a problem. Two of my revisions have the same downgrade version, but none of them is the head. But Alembic also has the merge command. There is now a new revision, which has two childs. This way, if I downgrade, both versions will be rollbacked. And if I upgrade again, both revisions will be applied. Okay, let's make a quick recap. I've installed Alembic in my project. I've initiated Alembic. This way I have the configuration file ready for the connection. I've edited my configuration file, alembic.ini, to indicate the URL of the database. I've created several revisions. I've also downgraded some revisions. When some revisions are made in parallel Git branches, I can merge them with the merge command. That's all for this video. I hope you learned something new today. Leave a comment if you think I've missed something important. Don't forget to subscribe and see you soon. Bye!